The long search has begun. The multiverse is under threat, and I now have one person as part of the team. Coordinator Sigma, otherwise known as the Doctor, travels by TARDIS through the multiverse. Our next destination is Dimension 111. In this universe, the Doctor in his 10th incarnation was never radiated to save his dear friend. He survived his encounter with the Master on Christmas Day and lived on. Many years passed until he met Amy Pond, in the wrong order. He meets a very young Amelia Pond whilst regenerating. Within hours, he is taken care of, he disappears in his blue box. Until 12 years later, the story begins in 2008.
So, where have you dropped me off this time? Countryside. Definitely Earth. Someone's back garden. Interesting choice. Hello? Anyone in? Hello? Sorry, I seem to have ended up in your back garden somehow. Hello? Oh, nobody's in. Oh well.
White meal. My theories. Breaking and entering. Send me some backup. I've got him restrained. Oh, you! Sit still.
You hit me. Hard.
Cricket bat. You were breaking and entering.
You've handcuffed me!
Do you want to shut up now? I've got backup on the way.
Yes, sorry. I probably should. You're a policewoman. Who lives here?
I live here.
And you happened to be on duty?
Don't be difficult.
What are you doing?
Sarge, better hurry up. We've got a deluded one.
Wait, there's something I'm missing. Something here. In this room. My sonic screwdriver. Where's my screwdriver?
What?
A small tube and blue on the end. Have you seen it?
No.
Must have fallen out when you hit me. You need to uncuff me.
Don't be ridiculous.
You say you live here, yes?
Yeah, I do. What of it?
How many rooms are there on this level?
What?
Tell me.
5 rooms.
6 rooms.
6?
Look behind you.
There are only...
There's something in this room that doesn't want to be seen. Look behind you, even if you don't want to.
That's not possible. How is that possible?
It's a perception filter. The position you've cuffed me to has meant I was able to see it.
A whole room. I've missed a whole room.
Wait, come back. Don't go any nearer.
A whole room.
You need to uncuff me so I can find out why it's there.
I don't have the key. I lost it.
How could you have lost it? Come back! No, don't.
What's in there?
Nothing.
Whatever made that perception filter has stopped you seeing the room. What makes you think you can trust anything in that room? Please, get out!
What did you say your screwdriver was? Small tube, blue on the end?
Silver tube, yes!
It's here.
Must have rolled under the door.
Yeah, must have. then it just jumped up on the table.
Get out of there! Now!
Oh, what was it covered in?
Get out!
Here's your tube thing.
Thank you. Right, that'll buy us a minute or two. Oh, what's the alien done to you?
What's that light around the door?
Ah, no idea. Run, your backup is coming. I'll be fine.
There is no backup.
I heard you on the radio. You called for backup.
It's a pretend radio.
Aren't you a policewoman?
I'm a kissogram.
What?
But it's just a man.
It's not. A man and a dog. Look at their faces, moving simultaneously. The same being.
But that's not...
It is possible. They've messed up the speech inhibitors. A man growling like a dog.
What? I'm sorry, but what?
It's one creature, but disguised as two. Bit of a rush job, though. Begs the question of where this creature got the pattern from. We need a psychic link or a live feed. Now. You don't have to kill us. We have backup.
There isn't any.
Right. That was a clever lie. But yes, we are alone, not a threat to you. Let us go.
What is that?
Sorry, did we say there wasn't any backup? We lied again. There is.
Where is he going?
Hang on. Come on, we need to get out of the house. Come on, to the TARDIS.
The what?
That blue box in your garden. Come on!
What?
I know, it's weird, but trust me on this.
Right. How is it?
What? He's coming. Come on. Get in.
But I remember.
Come on! I'm really sorry, I don't have time. It's big on the inside, and I'm an alien.
But it was destroyed.
What?
When I was a little girl.
What are you talking about? You... You've seen me before.
Yeah, I have.
And you forgot.
It was years ago. You were hurt.
Don't tell me anything about my future. That's dangerous foreknowledge. I'd rather not have.
Sorry.
How long ago for you?
12.
Oh dear.
What?
What was your name?
Amy. Amy Pond.
Amy Pond. There's something special about you.
How?
Well, I haven't met you yet. Not until today. That meeting we have when you're a child. That's not happened yet for me.
What are you talking about?
I'm still figuring that out. A kissogram?
Yeah.
Why were you pretending to be a policewoman?
You broke into my house. It was this or a French maid.
Right. Well, it's all modern nowadays. Anyway.
What's going on?
An alien convict has been living in your spare room disguised as a man and a dog. And some aliens are about to incinerate your house. So it's being broadcast to the TARDIS. Is this just a proximity range? But to affect the TARDIS communication system too? Seems odd. It's the whole world.
What?
The message from the other aliens. It's worldwide. Wait, what's that? No!
What is it? What's that sound?
It's the cloister bell. The TARDIS has detected danger in the immediate area. Maybe we can land on the spaceship above. Reason with them?
And this prisoner zero guy?
We'll take him to them. Maybe. What? The atmosphere has been locked. Nothing gets in or out. They plan to boil the planet.
Then how do we find prisoner zero?
The old-fashioned way. Come on!
Wait, it might be out there.
No, long gone. It's likely finding a way to blend in and hide amongst the locals.
How long do we have?
Well, for a planet of this size with your basic molten core, you need a 40% fission blast, so that would be...
Well?
20 minutes.
We have 20 minutes? Whoa! What's that?
Spaceship. I recognise those markings. The Atraxi. A space police force.
And it's come to Earth.
To scan the planet, more than likely. And that's our cue to find Prisoner Zero as soon as possible.
Where do we go?
The town square? I mean, look at the sun. The force field has distorted your access to it, and people are bound to be coming out in numbers. Let's go. Oh, there they all are.
Staring at the sun.
Typical. End of the world, getting filmed on a video phone.
Who are you, really?
I'm the Doctor.
How are you here, and not hurt?
Stop that. I can't know details about my future.
But why? What's happened? How is this possible?
It's a big universe, Amy. Anything is possible. I'm a time traveller. I've been travelling alone for a bit, avoided Earth for a while, and just hit the randomizer and ended up here. It's just coincidence.
There's no such thing as coincidence.
As we've just learned from your previous encounter with me, which I'm yet to experience, something connected us. You seem to have a habit of doing that.
There!
I see him!
What do you want?
The Atraxi are after you, Prisoner Zero. They're scanning this entire planet for any spike in alien technology. And I've got this sonic screwdriver.
What are you doing?
Cover your ears.
What?
Do you think they'll notice? Ooh, bad decision changing your form in front of them, Prisoner Zero.
Prisoner Zero is located.
Yes!
Prisoner Zero, it is trains.
Something is coming, Doctor. Something to end everything.
What's that supposed to mean?
All universes will die.
Wait, was that it? Doctor?
Yes, it was. Something's off.
It's all over, right?
They just left. No, this doesn't work like that. Can I have your phone?
Why?
Please.
Sure.
Just giving it a boost. I didn't say you could go. Article 57 of the Shadow Proclamation. This is a fully established level 5 planet, and you were going to burn it. Did you think no one was watching? I want you back here now. Signal just cut out.
So?
Signal never cuts out, not on this. No one have upgraded the phone signal like this. Something's wrong.
Are you all right?
Something that Prisoner Zero said. All universes will die.
He was lying then.
Back to the TARDIS. Now!
Hello, dear fellow.
What?
Who are you?
A traveller. Much like your friend here.
What's that metal tube doing next to the TARDIS?
It's another TARDIS, my dear. Now, to business.
To business?
I understand that you are the Doctor, yes?
You shouldn't even be here.
I'm not of your universe, dear boy. I am from Dimension 63.
Well, your clothes certainly gave that away.
Yes, I suppose they would. My TARDIS index told me you were someone that ran away from your duties on Gallifrey. Isn't that so?
I did my duty. There was a time war, and I fought.
Hello, Doctor.
Who are you?
I'm the Warden of Time. The multiverse is dying, and we need your help.
My help to do what?
We're assembling a team. You see, your universe doesn't have much time. Multiversal wave has just currently made its way through this one.
You're talking in the past tense.
You are in a unique position, Doctor.
The force field that the Atraxi raised has slowed the rate of the multiversal wave, but only for a short time, which has given us the opportunity to land here and ask you to join us.
Me and Amy.
Doctor, you must understand that because we Time Lords are time-sensitive and tangled in the web of time, we have a certain immunity. But bringing your human companion on board would just tear her timeline apart. You must see this. It's irresponsible.
You're not the Doctor.
No, I'm not. From your point of view. But I am the Doctor, nonetheless.
Still early days. Still know what it means to be the Doctor.
My boy, I have lost my universe, and we are running out of time in yours. My family, my friends, all living beings in my universe are dead, and we must set it right. So stop dilly-dallying.
And that's what's happening through the force field. It's getting darker. What's happening?
The sun. It's going out.
Yes, well, it takes 8 minutes for the light of the sun to reach this planet. That time has now caught up with us. And we are now out of time.
So there's no stopping it?
Not now. You must join us if there are any chance of stopping whoever created this wave.
But who did create it?
We don't know that. What we do know is that we have a chance. We wish to save as many as we can by whatever means.
Yet you'll let Amy die.
Doctor, please be reasonable.
No. You don't get to choose who lives and who dies.
Time is up, Doctor.
At least take Amy with you.
You're not listening, Doctor. The timeline would just be...
I don't care.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Very well. Get on board.
And my TARDIS?
Come on, Doctor.
I...
No, there is no time.
This TARDIS is different.
Quite so.
Let me help.
No, I'm perfectly capable, thank you very much.
I remember being you once. You could barely fly this thing.
Don't touch the controls. I know what I'm doing, sir. I am a Matrix observer and a coordinator. I know perfectly well how TARDISes work.
Our universes truly have diverged from one another.
That is the way of the multiverse.
What was that?
We have entered the multiversal stream, akin to your traditional time vortex.
And you do this?
It is my purpose, to bring everyone together.
That sound... it's the time vortex.
Doctor...
Amy?
What's happening to me?
Amy, you're... you're disappearing!
We warned you, Doctor. Her timeline is collapsing!
Doctor!
Stop this! Bring her back!
There is still a way, Doctor.
It's all over. My life. Everything I've ever known.
We have other dimensions to explore. There is still hope. Trust me.
No.
What?
I said no!
There's nothing you can do, Doctor.
Take us back. We can go back in time. Stop this from happening.
That is what we are trying to do. The multiversal wave didn't begin in your universe.
Then where?
We don't know yet. But we are working our way ahead of the wave. Trying to gather the best of the multiverse as we go along. And then we will create a working team to finally solve this problem.
And do you think there aren't other versions of you in the multiverse trying to do the same?
There is only one wave. One probability. The team must form from across the multiverse. There must be no no chance of any variant outcomes.
We can't let them die.
No, we can't.
So we're agreed then. We must work together to restore the multiverse.
I see. Where do we go next?
Carpathia, 1982, Dimension 15.